Hello. Today I would like to discuss about the Android service. Service is an application component that executes tasks in the background without affecting the user's current activity. You know the Unix or Linux command. When you give any command with the ampersand, then it will goes to background process and command is the prompt is ready to accept another command. That is a foreground. You have to do your work and this process is executed in background. That is, long running tasks are the background processes. By default, service always runs in the main UI thread. Then service, this is the flowchart for service, started service and bound service. And again, started service is divided into foreground service and background service, intent service, job intent service. Service foreground and background, you have to stop specifically for the started service. Started services is started with the help of an Android component, activity, broadcast receiver, content provider, and service. They are started with the any component, therefore it is called started service, and it will start by start service method and stop by stop self or stop service method. By default it has one-way communication. It started with stop self methods. When service once started, it's running in the background indefinitely, even when the start shared component is also destroyed. Started component is also destroyed. It is always executing on the background, and no UI is there because it is a background process. We should stop the service after the task is finished by using stop service or stop self methods. Then bound service. The service is called a bound service when Android component simply bind to the particular service. That is a client server interface. Bind service with the three components. The components are activity, content provider, and the service itself. Broadcast receiver can never bind the service. And binding to the service is achieved with the help of a special method, bind service. A bind service exists as long as there is at least one component bound to it. For unbinding service, the component unbind the service, then service should be destroyed. Bind service with the activity, content provider, and service components with the help of bind service method. When all calling components are destroyed, the service also destroyed. Bound service continuously interacts with calling components, and it is a two-way communication. Now we will see the flowchart. This is a started service and this is a bound service. Call to start service, then on create, on start command, service is running, service is stopped by itself or client, on destroy, and service shutdown. This is the unbounded service, that is started service. This is the life cycle of service, and this is after on create. If service is bounded service, then onBind method is there, and it calls, it bind with the client. Clients are bound to service. Then when clients unbind by calling unbind service, then on unbind the service is destroyed and service is shut down, bounded service. On start command, this method is called when any other component like say an activity requests the service to be started by calling start service. It is your responsibility to stop the service when the corresponding work is done by using stop sale or stop service methods. When you start any service, then it is the duty to stop the service. Unbind, call this method when another component wants to bind the service by calling bind service. To implement this, you must provide an interface that clients use in order to communicate with the service. Interface is required because client and server communication is there. Inter-process communication is there, therefore interface is required here. It returns an iBinder object. In case of started service, iBinder object returns null. If bounded service, then it returns an iBinder object. If you don't want to allow binding, then return null. The system unbind on unbind. The system calls this method when all clients are disconnected from a particular interface published by the service. On rebind, again it is connected to the service after it had previously been notified that all are disconnected in on unbind. After on unbind, again you want to connect, then use on rebind. On create, the system calls this method when the service is created first using on start command. Or unbind, on unbind, on bind. It is required to perform a one-time setup. On create, it's executed once only. The system calls the method when the service is created first. On start or unbind. And on destroy, this method is called when the service is no longer used and is being destroyed. Your service should implement this in order to clean up any resources such as threads, registered listeners, receivers, etc. This method is called to when the service is no longer used and is being destroyed. This is the basics of, these are the basics of service, its types and service lifecycle methods. Then let us see how to execute any service, started service. How to implement that using Kotlin. Here, four files are there. First, you have to create new project. Then it will create main activity, activity main, random number. First, you have to execute the application. Then you understand. Three buttons are there. After clicking, my service application is the name of app, my service application. Three buttons are there: start service, stop service, service stats. Here we have to design start service, stop service and service stats. In design code, you have to create three buttons. Its name is start service, stop service, service stats. Wrap content, and here we have to implement on click event for start service, stop service and service stats. In main activity, in execution, after clicking start service, it displays service started. Stop service, it displays service destroyed. And service starts, service is stopped, therefore service is stopped. It gives status of service. Then when you start any service, service started. In here, random number generator is there. Background, it create random number. Until you stop the service, it automatically creates numbers. And it is a background process, it continually creates random numbers. Here main activity dot kt, here main program, here random number service class is there, random number service kt, This is the first, you have to create new project, then main activity, activity main, then create new service. How to create that service? Create on, right click on this new service and service. It will create random number service dot kt. Class random number service and it extended from service. Here threading is used, m handler and m runnable. We have to use thread to execute the service. Override one on start to create started a service, toast service started. Here delay 5000 seconds, you have to give the delay for started service. Return service start sticky. Here